Hello. So, good morning, everyone. So, we are going now to say find each trigonometric ratio using segments. Hello. So, good morning, everyone. So, we are going now to say find each trigonometric ratio using segments. Okay. So, I will give you an example. First example. This is just a continuation of what we discussed yesterday about the trigonometric ratios. Okay. So, still, in order for us to solve the or finding the corresponding trigonometric ratio based on the given, so we have here find its trigonometric ratio using segments. Number one, sine theta. So we have here a given triangle. So we are going to determine the value of sine theta. Okay. So in solving the value of sine theta, always remember yung ating SOHCAHTOA, so that we have you have guide, no, in order for you to easily determine the corresponding trigonometric ratio. No? So this is SOHCAHTOA. Okay. TOA. Okay. So this is letter A. So sine, opposite over adjacent, hypotenuse. We have cosine adjacent over hypotenuse, and we have the tangent opposite over adjacent. So in this case, this is SO. So this is SO. So number one is sine theta. So we have to determine the value of this trigonometric ratio using segments. No? Segments ang alamin natin. No? So sine theta, that is opposite over hypotenuse. Opposite over hypotenuse. Okay? So, the opposite of sine theta or angle theta here, this is the angle theta. Ito yung angle theta natin. So, yung opposite natin is side QR. QR. So, itong side na to. So, this is side QR. So, your answer is opposite niya is QR. Okay. Over the hypotenuse of this right triangle is the opposite of this, we call this right angle, no, Q. No? So, meaning to say, this segment PR, so itong segment na to, this is our hypotenuse. No? So, this is our hypotenuse. So, this is segment PR. So, this is QR over PR. PR. Okay? So, simple lang, no? So, meaning to say, that the sine theta based on the given triangle is QR over PR. Okay? So that's for number one. So how about number two? So number two, we have cosine theta. So dito tayo sa ka. Since cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. So cosine theta, since the angle theta here is an angle A or FEG or GEF. Angle GEF. Ito. So, since cosine theta is adjacent, so we have to look for adjacent. So, adjacent of this angle, hindi rin ito ang adjacent niya. No? So, because this is the hypotenuse, since the opposite of this right angle. So, this is the hypotenuse. So, the adjacent of cosine theta here is line segment EG. No? So, this is EG. So, meaning to say that this adjacent is EG. So this is EG over the hypotenuse, no? Hypotenuse of this theta based on the given triangle is EF. So this is the hypotenuse. So therefore, EG over hypotenuse, that is E segment EF or sine EF. So that's for number two. No? So this will be now your answer. Okay? So, we will go to number three problem. Tangent alpha or tangent theta. So tangent theta, we have to clear this. So tangent theta is equal to, so since tau ito, that is tau, that is opposite over adjacent. This is opposite over adjacent. So tangent is opposite over adjacent. So the opposite of this theta, angle theta, is this side, xz. So this value becomes equals to xz, segment xz over the a here, adjacent of this angle is this side yz. This side yz. Because this xy side, this is the hypotenuse since the opposite of this right angle. So this is, so meaning tangent theta is opposite over adjacent or xz over yz. This is yz. So yz. So therefore, this will be now your answer. Tangent theta, based on the given triangle na ito, this triangle is xz over yz. How about number 4? No? Sine theta. No? Sine theta. So this angle, sine theta. So this is angle theta is equal to the opposite over hypotenuse. So no? This is so. So this is so. No? Is OH. That is sine opposite over hypotenuse. So opposite over hypotenuse. So the opposite of this angle is yon na side. Itong side na to. That is AB. So your final answer is equals to AB over. So this is AB over. The hypotenuse is the opposite of this angle. Right angle is EC. So this is AC. So meaning, the sine theta based on the given right triangle here is equals to AB over AC. So that's for number four. So we'll go to number five. Okay. We will go to number five. So number five, cosine theta. So this is five is cosine theta. So based on a triangle TSU. So we have sine theta here. Cosine theta. So this angle, no? In relation to this angle. So this is angle theta. The cosine is opposite, no? Diba? Cosine that is ka adjacent over hypotenuse. No? So ano bang adjacent ng angle na to? So ang adjacent nito ay SU. So hindi pwedeng TU kasi this is an hypotenuse. So adjacent of this angle is SU. So therefore, SU over a hypotenuse that is TU. TU. Okay. So this will be now your answer. Okay. How about number 6? Tangent theta. So we'll go on number 6. So tangent theta. So tangent theta. So this is now the angle theta. So or MNL. Or LNM. Angle LNM. Or angle theta. So tangent says that is opposite over adjacent. So tangent is opposite over adjacent. So the opposite of this angle is line segment LM. So this is line segment LM. So meaning to say, so this is LM over our adjacent is MN. Adjacent of this angle. Adjacent of this angle is MN. So therefore, LM over MN or NM. Doesn't matter. So, meaning to say, this is your answer of tangent we'll try to check our answer based on our answer key. Okay, we'll try to check answer key natin. Okay, so QR over PR for number one. For number two, we have cosine theta EG over EF. Tangent natin is XZ over YZ. Number four natin is sine theta is AB over AC. And number five natin is cosine theta is SU over TU. And number six natin is tangent theta over LM over MN. Okay? So, that's all. And abangan yung ating short quiz mamaya sa ating klase. Okay? So, that's all and thank you.